Today's class is chemical synthesis of nanoparticles. In the last class, I have inculcated about the physical synthesis of nanoparticles. Today, let us see about the chemical synthesis of nanoparticles. So, most of the nanoparticles are being synthesized by the chemical method. Because the particles, the nanoparticles which are received by the chemical synthesis are having higher purity and higher surface area. That's why most of the nanoparticles are being synthesized by the chemical processes. There are two important steps in the chemical synthesis of nanoparticles. One is the nucleation. Nucleation means synthesis of nucleus in the nanoparticles. And the second step in the chemical synthesis is Ostwald and digestive ripening. Ostwald ripening, what it says means high solubility and surface area of the particles accelerate the particles to redissolve themselves and ultimately to form the nanoparticle. That is the Ostwald ripening. That is the first point in the Ostwald ripening. And second point in the Ostwald ripening is, Ostwald means Ostwald. Ostwald theory you have studied in your plus two level. So Ostwald is a chemist. He represents that theory. The first theory I have mentioned. The second theory, what it says means change in the solubility of the particles leads to the formation of the nanoparticle. That is the second law in the Ostwald ripening. Whereas the digestive ripening, what it says means it is inversely proportional to the Ostwald ripening. Smaller particles are formed due to the expense of the larger particle, that is dealt in the digestive ripening. So these two important steps, one first step is nucleation and second step is Ostwald and digestive ripening. These are the two important steps which are availing in the chemical synthesis of nanoparticles. Regarding methods, so many methods are available. Such methods are co-precipitation, salt gel method, microemulsions, hydrothermal synthesis, microwave synthesis, sonochemical synthesis, polyol, CVD. CVD means chemical vapor deposition. So in the last class I have explained about the PVD. PVD means physical vapor deposition. Here CVD means chemical vapor deposition and electrospinning. Then apart from that, several methods are there, and these are the common methods. Methods are co-precipitation, salt gel method, microemulsions, hydrothermal synthesis, microwave synthesis, sonochemical synthesis. Sonochemical means by means of sound. It is also a chemical process for the production of the nanoparticle. Then polyol, CVD, electrospinning. Let us see one by one. First, we'll see about the salt gel method. Salt gel is a chemical process used for the synthesis of nanofilms, nanofibers, and nanopowders. Salt, you have heard about the term salt. Salt is nothing but it is the colloidal or molecular suspension, that the ions are dissolved in the solvent. Such type of material is called as salt. Gel is a semi-rigid mass. When it is being formed means when the solvent is being evaporated from the salt leads to the formation of gel. So salt is a colloidal substance. It's a colloidal material that is dissolved in a solvent. Gel, when the solvent is being evaporated, the salt is converted into gel. That is, it's a semi-rigid mass. Okay. When the gel is being formed, automatically it will be forming the nanoparticles. Nanoparticles with a complex network. Such particles will be formed by the salt gel method. Gel is formed by two steps. One is the hydrolysis and another one is calcination. Calcination is thermal treatment. So by means of hydrolysis, we can get the metal oxo or metal hydroxo complexes will be formed. Then in the second step, calcination, that is the thermal treatment. By the thermal treatment, the rest of the water is removed from the materials and form a metal oxo network will be formed. Then the ultimate product will be in the nano size, having nanopores like that can get by means of salt gel method. Then the next method is polyol method. Polyols are alcohols consisting of number of alcohols. So that's why the polyols are being used as reductant and also the solvent. Okay, polyol is nothing but polyalcohols consisting of number of alcoholic group. So that it can be used as the reductant and also the solvent. So these polyols are effectively used for the synthesis of nanoparticles. how it is being used means the precursor salts, the polyols, and also the solid materials are being mixed, stirred, and they have been heated up to the boiling point of the temperature, up to the boiling point of the polyol temperature. Okay, so that the ultimate product will be the nanoparticles. So again, I am repeating, the precursor salts and the polyols and the soluble solids are being mixed and they have been stirred. After stirring, they have been dried to the temperature of up to the boiling point of the polyols, so that the ultimate product will be in the nano size. The zinc oxide nanoparticles, zinc oxide ZNO nanoparticles, are also being produced by the polyol method. The precursor salts such as zinc nitrate, zinc chloride, and zinc acetate are being mixed with the polyols to produce the zinc oxide nanoparticles. The next method is microwave synthesis. Here the microwaves are being used, the frequencies of 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz wavelength microwaves are being used for the production of nanoparticles, and they are having the wavelength of 1 mm to 1 meter. Such wavelengths are being used for the production of nanoparticles. There are two mechanisms involved in the synthesis of nanoparticles by means of microwave. One is the dipole interaction and another one is ionic contact. So by these two mechanisms we can segregate the nanoparticles from the deposited sites. Okay. Then the next method is electrospinning. Electrospinning, the electrostatic forces are being used for the production of nanofibers and nanomaterials. It can be done by two methods. One is the electrospraying and the second one is electrospinning. Let us see the electrospinning. Electrospinning means a specific cone. That cone is called as Taylor cone. Taylor cone, which is filled up with the polymeric materials, and the electric current is induced in the Taylor cone. The tip of the Taylor cone will be ejecting the polymers, and that will be formed to the fiber. That fiber is in the nano size, that is called as nanofiber. So that diagram and the reactions will be given in are given in your material. So by when you are studying this lecture, you just compare with the video. Okay, then only you can understand the topic. Okay. And then the next method is co-precipitation method. Here the inorganic salts and solvents are being mixed and they will be converted into precipitates. Then the precipitates are washed and dried to the temperature of 500 degrees Celsius for 3 days. We can get the nanoparticles. That is the co-precipitation method. And the last method is sonochemical synthesis. Sonochemical synthesis, by means of sonochemical synthesis, mesoporous titanium oxide nanoparticles are being produced. And the temperature, here the temperature is up to 5000 Kelvin, and the pressure up to 20 megapascal are being used for the production of the nanoparticles. Okay, up to these are the chemical synthesis of nanoparticles. So you just keep in your mind, most of the nanoparticles are prepared by or synthesized by the chemical methods. Such methods are co-precipitation, sol gel, microemulsions, hydrothermal synthesis, microwave synthesis, sonochemical synthesis, polyol, CVD, and electrospinning. CVD means chemical vapor deposition. Here in your syllabus, the selective methods have been given. The methods are sol gel, co-precipitation, then microwave synthesis, sonochemical synthesis, polyol, and electrospinning methods are given in your schedule. Okay. So again, I am repeating, sol gel is nothing but it is the solvent and gel, that is a semi-rigid mass. The semi-rigid mass will be giving the nanoparticles when the solvent, when the liquid, when the water is being evaporated from the sol, the gel is formed, and the gel will be producing the nanoparticles. Then regarding polyol method, the polyalcohols, polyols are being used for the synthesis of nanoparticles. Then regarding microwave synthesis, the microwaves with the frequencies of 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz are being used for the production of nanoparticles. And the electrospinning method, electrospinning, here a special cone, Taylor cone, is being used for the production of the nanofibers. And the last method is co-precipitation method. Co-precipitation method means here the simple organic salts, inorganic salts and the solvents are being mixed for the production of the nanoparticles. And the last method is sonochemical method. Here the temperature up to 5000 Kelvin and also the pressure 20 megapascal are being used for the, are being applied to the materials for the production of nanoparticles. Thank you very much.